Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Emnix Plays Path of Exile Prophecy League. In this episode, I think we are going to look at completing Act 4. I made the run past Belly of the Beast into the Harvest already. Sort of that's like a little time-consuming area that really doesn't have too much relevance on, the game itself. So I decided to just rush past that area and let's just deal with the three bosses today. And then deal with Malachi. We're level 42. This area is level 40. That should be good enough to deal with Malachi, I believe. I'm not too scared, but I mean, you never know, right? You really never know when it comes to fighting this boss. Let's just get into it. What have I been doing for the last couple days? Well, offline, I just sort of AFK'd. While watching a movie, and a lot of people kept messaging me and they kept asking for to trade skill gems. And I'm very surprised. Like, I'm gonna give a tip for you guys out there, for you those of you who are trying to make, some quick currency, at the beginning of the league. Sell your skill gems, the ones that are exclusive to your class, and that includes stuff like cast on damage taken, increased duration, stuff like that. They seem to be selling for quite a bit. I can sell my gems for one fusing each, and I don't mind revealing this because really making money, it's not too much of a big deal to me. And if more people do this, I don't really care. But if you sell your gems for one fusing each, just put them on a public stash tab. Before, it was kind of hard to do since you had to use acquisition and all that. It was kind of a pain to do, not worth the time. But now you throw it onto a public stash tab, sell it for a fusing, someone's gonna buy your skill gems. So skill gems still have some value in this game, even though they are being sold by the vendors, because of the fact that certain gems are exclusive to certain classes. You end up with a little bit of with some skew in supply and demand. So yeah, that's one way. I think I managed to make a good 30 to 40 fusings doing that. Just from this morning. I was working from home today, so I got a chance to sort of keep my client open while working on my laptop. And yeah, it was a great way to make money without, obviously farming will make money faster. It's not, I don't think it's worth just sitting around and trading. But if you have some spare time, if you're watching some movies on Netflix, just AFK in town and see if anybody wants to trade with you. That's what I did, and then now I'm 20 to 30 fusings richer for it, right? So that was pretty nice. Other than that, our build is going fine. This tabula is doing wonders for our build. The fact that we found this tabula rasa, we have so much DPS going on right now, 542. That's insane, by the way. Just for like, what is this, level 42, Act 4 normal? That's actually insane. Everything's just getting one shot, and the only thing we have to worry about is tankiness, which is what we spec'd into, right? Like, we don't have that much damage on our tree. It's all HP, and if it's not HP, it's like strength nodes, which actually benefits us. Like, sometimes stat nodes for a character, it might not benefit you too much, but I feel like this is benefiting us quite a bit because we're using Iron Will, which is giving us more spell damage, and for every 5 strength we get like some armor and some HP. Every 2 strength gives us 1 life, right? So every 10 strength node that we put in, we get 5 life out of it. Which doesn't seem like much, but you put on like, what's this, 232 strength? That's what? That's like 116 extra life. I mean, that's a pretty big deal. Factor in all the multipliers and everything, you end up with like an extra 300 life or so. This is the wrong way. So yeah, right now our build, a lot of it is just we're going to be getting a lot of strength. That's what the build is going to be, and after that we're gonna start working on life and life regen and all that good stuff. But I want to get to the endurance charges really quickly, that way I can do righteous fire, maybe earlier, maybe before we get to Act 3 Cruel. I'm not too sure when we can do it. We're probably going to need a Rise of the Phoenix. But that's sort of like a late game item. And by late game, I mean like level... What's the requirement of a Rise of Phoenix? Like 60 or something like that? That's pretty far off. If we can maybe start using Righteous Fire when we get to level... I don't know, level 50? Well, maybe not level 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 8, 9, 10, 11. After 11 levels. So 55. Or 53. Huh, that's quite a bit. But yeah, maybe once we can start using Righteous Fire 53, this might pay off, you know? We'll have to see. Man, level 53 is when we can start using Righteous Fire. That's not that far off, to be honest. 11 levels? It might seem like a lot, but if you think about it, it really isn't a lot. We can get there very quickly. That's like, what, like two or three acts? So it does end up being Act 3 Cruel. That's alright, I guess. Okay, Chevron. God, Flame Blast just does so much damage. So insane. Thank God they like stay in one spot too. They don't move around. If he had moved around a bit more, maybe this would have been a bit harder. But that was not the case. Heat Shiver. Is it better than what I got? Probably not. This helmet is pretty good. It gives a good amount of ES. Not that I need it. I would prefer to have life. But it gives ES and resistance. It's like effective life and resistance. And I am totally okay with something like that. Now for the end game, the plan is we go Iron Will, we stack multipliers on Flame Surge, and for trash mobs we kill with RF, for bosses we kill with Flame Surge with a bunch of multipliers. And then we stack a lot of HP, we stack a lot of armor so that we have good tankiness and good damage mitigation. We are not going to have Fortify, which does suck a little. I mean, what can you do about that? Maybe you use Whirling Blades or something? I didn't really think about that part, but yeah, maybe it'll be a non-Fortify build, but you're going to have a lot of armor, and hopefully that's enough to mitigate, you know, all the bad things coming at us. I think we're going to run a Determination Aura for even more armor. And then we'll have to see, I guess. Alright, this guy shouldn't be a problem. We can probably kill him off the screen. As long as he doesn't move too much. Like, it doesn't even matter where I'm standing. Now, this guy actually does quite a bit of damage, which causes me to worry a little about what would happen if I were to fight Malachi. I'm assuming Malachi does more damage than these guys. Anyways, we finished this pretty quickly. I mean, it's a sign when you can clear this quickly on pretty much a boss stage. I mean, this is like the boss level. When you can clear everything this quickly, I think it's a good sign that you're ready to move on. So I am feeling very confident, you know, about our current situation. And in part, it's really thanks to you guys who have been watching, who have been leaving comments and giving advice on what to do. It's really helped me a lot. And in part, it's thanks to my own RNG for getting a Tabula Rasa so early on, which gave us the ability to just purely focus on defense while the Tabula provided the offense. So, you know, a lot of things have been going for us, you know, going well for us, is what I mean to say. Oh, look at that. Spell damage, cast speed. We lose resistances, yes, but how can I say no? That seems like a pretty good amulet. What happens to our resistances? I mean, it's fine. More spell damage, more cast speed, some intelligence. More intelligence than I had before. I mean, this is an awesome amulet for me. This is amazing. Wow. Okay, great. I'll put this in the backups as well. And some gems to sell. Collocation. Wait. Wasn't there a superior gem that I found? Yeah, here's a quality gem. Quality mana leech. Should I sell it? Might as well sell it for one elk. Hopefully someone buys it. If they don't, whatever. No skin off my back. Alright, moving on. We're ready for Malachi. Alright, Piety, let's do this. I don't know how safe I'm going to be. One thing that I'm missing right now at this moment is mana regeneration. Mana regen is really bad. I'm relying purely on my potions. And I guess once you go Righteous Fire, you don't really need mana regen anymore. But at this moment, I really do. Kill me! Alright. Kill me! Alright, so far so good. Things are going very well. Yeah, that was easy. Very, very easy. Alright. Piety, you're dead. I get it. I don't need to see you die. I've seen it plenty of times. Okay. Wow, and we are very tanky too. I'm really liking this build. At least so far. And it has to do with the fact that Flame Blast is just so strong. We're playing a game of multipliers right now. You know, all our support gems are multipliers. Flame Blast itself is a multiplier. Just multiplying all the damage scaling. It's a very old school way to do it. I think in the past everyone just abused multipliers. And I understand why. I get it now. It's pretty strong. I mean, similar to like Earthquake, right? That's why people use Earthquake, because Earthquake has a, what is it, 60% multiplier? And what, Incinerate used to have a multiplier too? Or maybe it still does. So similarly, when we're using Righteous Fire, that thing has a multiplier. And then Flame Surge is a multiplier for things that are burning. So I think we'll be able to dish out a lot of damage with it. That's the plan at least. We'll have to see how it goes. And then with that, we don't really need to skill into the damage too much. And the plan is that we just do pure defense on the passive tree. And let the skill gems take care of themselves in terms of damage. Hopefully it works. I'm not sure. We'll have to see. I suspect it will work though. Alright, we are done. Okay, I'm not gonna stick around. No, I'm gonna watch his death animation. We went through the effort of killing him. There. Malachi is dead. I'm not gonna take your portal, I'm gonna take my own portal. Alright, time to move on into Cruel. Oyun takes us into Twilight Strand. Someone wants to buy a less duration. Okay. Invite to party. Less duration. I believe I have one over here. See? More multipliers. I think this is why people want these kinds of items. All right. Let me go restock this Lesteration. Lesteration, where would I find it? Act 3? Here we go. I mean, this is basically what I've been doing all day, just selling gems while on my spare time. Or while having some downtime. Oh, what an interesting shield. Not good enough though, so let's sell them. Alright, it is time for Cruel. This area is level 40. We're 42, so we're still good. Higher resistances, 67, 75, 66. Not as good as I would like, but I'm sure it'll get better over time. I mean, it's already pretty decent considering the fact that we don't have an armor piece for our resistances. The fact that we're playing a Marauder, I guess, really helps. Since, since we get resistances through our passive tree, or there are very good resistance nodes nearby, is what I mean to say. So I guess having low resistance on our gear is not as big of a factor, since we can just get it off the tree. Like we got diamond skin, cold resistance, and fire resistance. We don't have lightning, but that's okay. And what are we missing? Fire and lightning. Wow, I'm gonna two-shot this guy. Get wrecked. Okay. We can probably go pretty fast. We can probably get to, maybe Brutus today? Is that possible? Let's go for a fire ring. What are my prophecies? You will enter a hidden veil area that contains powerful enemies, and you will seek out and destroy a group of 7 powerful undead. God damn it. Should I do this? In normal. Okay, let's do a couple Dry Lakes runs. And this way we can complete our prophecies. And that way we don't have to, it won't just sit in our queue like this. So let's run a couple Dried Lakes and see if we can complete this prophecy. So what was it? You will hidden veil area with powerful enemies. Okay. I'm sure we can go pretty fast doing this. Look how much damage we're doing. We're like one-shotting everything. Pretty much the first stage of Flame Blast is killing people. These mobs do not stand a chance. Look at that, the blues get one-shotted too. What about the yellows? Goodbye. Oh my god, Flame Blast is just so OP. Although, I guess we all knew that. You know, I'm just kind of late to the party. Like, I knew it was OP, but I've never experienced it for myself. Alright, I wonder how much it takes to kill Vol. I mean, he's a very tanky boss. How much was that? It was like, 1/5 of his HP? Maybe? Oh my god, get wrecked. Okay. But we are here to find that vault area. Not for anything else. Or that veil area. And to kill the undead whatevers. How am I gonna do this? Alright. But we're getting really good EXP over here. So I guess once we get into Act 1, we can just rush through that area. For those of you wondering, by the way, why am I here? I need to finish these prophecies before I enter Cruel. Otherwise, these prophecies will go to waste, you know? It's like, it's like you already paid to get your car washed on Sunday. You know, although I don't know if you ever schedule an appointment to get your car washed. You already paid. What's a good analogy? You already paid to go on vacation, you know, next week. And you found out that now you can go to Bahamas for free instead. And would you rather go to the Bahamas? Like, you can delay your Bahamas trip. But you know, I paid to go to New York this weekend. I'm gonna go. So that's basically what we're doing right here. We gotta complete our prophecies. Otherwise my coins will go to waste. But where the heck am I gonna find this Veil side area? And this army of undead? How am I gonna do this? Maybe I should go to areas which are... where you're more prone to finding undead mobs, maybe? Okay, let me try... making a few new instances and seeing if the prophecy triggers. No, it doesn't seem to. Alright, you know what? Okay, well, first of all, we're going this way on our tree. Let's try going to docks. I think there are some undead areas there, and it's really easy to find a veil area there as well. So let's do that. Here's a spell damage gloves. I mean, I could take it, but I don't really need it. But this thing isn't giving me resistances anyways. It's giving me some life, but... you know what? Fuck it. Let's do it. There. Now we're going all out damage. Okay, let's go to, the docks? I guess? And hopefully, over here, we will find that Veil side area. As well as those undead. Oh, this area is level 29. It's so low, though. I'm not gonna get any EXP here. There's really no point in coming here. God damn it, what should I do about these prophecies? Can I give them up? How about the aqueduct? You will enter a veil side area. Okay. Here's one prophecy that we can do. All right. Veil side area. I mean, these guys aren't even worth fighting. Do they even give EXP? Oh, they give coins. Alright, it kind of makes it worth it then. And I guess they give some drops. Alright, they're giving some form of EXP. All right, here we go.
Ancient foes open new paths to the land they live buried.
Okay, and what if this place has a group of powerful seven undead? Oh, it would be like the best combo ever. Do prophecies combo? I don't know. Anyways, this is I'm actually enjoying the Prophecy League more than the Perandis League. And like, I really did enjoy the Perandis League, but this feels more rewarding. Like, I want to go back to like easier levels and do my prophecies because it's so fun. Versus in Perandis, where you're just like rewarded by, oh god, get wrecked. Where you're rewarded by, you know, like finding a really nice unique or something. Okay, what's happening? What's happening here? There's a soul eater. What's he like? What am I looking at here? Well, he's dead. Is this my prophecy? It didn't seem too difficult. Then again, we have so much damage, I guess nothing seems difficult. Alright, we full cleared this area, I guess. You know, getting a side area isn't that bad because it, you can work towards completing your challenge of killing all, like, a bunch of Veil bosses, right? Yeah, so it's pretty good, nothing to complain about. Alright, so maybe we won't be able to get to Brutus today. We kind of wasted our time trying to do our prophecies. Which, honestly, I'm totally okay with. And I hope you guys don't mind either. You know, the point of this game is to farm. You know, a lot of the time is to farm up items, farm up EXP, farm up whatever. And in this league, sometimes it's farming up prophecies. Even though it might not be that rewarding at times, we're working towards a goal, right? Doing this, we're working towards completing a few challenges. We're working towards finding more Veil areas, which is nice. What's the other one? Group of seven powerful undead. We get to try out new stuff. We get to like see new prophecies. You know, I'm okay with that as well. So, you know, I'm enjoying myself so far. And, you know, I'm not really regretting the fact that, you know, we gotta do all these prophecies, even though we could be moving on to Cruel. We're gonna stay in normal Act 4 until we can finish our final prophecy. And then of course there's this one over here. You can enhance the quality of a weapon with a single whetstone, which is absolutely useless for me. Oh god. Goodbye. Because, you know, giving quality to a dagger doesn't do anything for spell damage. And I think I mentioned this in a previous episode as well. But that's okay. Damage isn't an issue anymore. Not to brag, but I'm just saying. You know? Alright. So what would this powerful undead minions look like? What would they look like? What am I looking for? That's the hard part. I don't know what I'm looking for. New. You will defeat seven powerful undead. Okay, here we go. Now we just gotta look for them. Are those it? They're colorful. And that one's undead. It's not very powerful though. Oh. Seven rare mobs? Is that what it is? Ah, prophecy complete. Okay, that is pretty cool. You got like rare mob septuplets right there. Is that how you say it? Seven of them? Septuplets? I mean, in Merciless, I can see that being really good, right? 7 rare mobs altogether. Really nice drops, really good quantity. If you did that on a map, it's even better. Higher chance to get rare map drops. That was pretty dope. I enjoyed it. Yeah, I'm liking it. Alright, let's put this into the sale tab. Put away the currency. So as you can see, I got 29 fusings now. All from just randomly selling skill gems. I would have had more, but I had to buy some chance orbs so I could, you know, buy more gems. You gotta spend money to make money, I'm just saying. It's a basic law of economics. Or finance. Or something like that. Now let's pick up a prophecy in Cruel. Seek prophecy. Ancient foes open new paths to the land they live barren. Okay, so another Veil Area prophecy. It has been 30 minutes. I think we can play for 10 more minutes. Maybe get to the ledge, and then we'll call it a day. And by a day, I mean an episode. Not a day, since I'll definitely be playing some more after this episode. I've been recording like crazy. I mean, you guys might not know, but I have like a backlog of like a week's worth of episodes, pretty much at this point in time. And I think what I might end up doing is maybe I'll start releasing episodes at a higher frequency, maybe 2 Path of Exile episodes a day. You know, maybe that'll be good, but I don't want to force myself to, you know, consistently dish out 2 Path of Exile episodes a day, because that means I have to record at least an hour every single day, or 1.5 hours. It might not seem like that, but that's a pretty large time commitment. You know, on days where I'm not tired, or on days where I am tired, where maybe I don't want to play, it means the next day I have to record 3 hours. You know, it adds up if you skip a day. So we will have to see. Ooh, here's the Veil Area. But right now, I'm just enjoying the game so much that I'm just on. You know, I'm playing like 2-3 hours at a time. Every day, and I don't feel tired afterwards. I just feel great. I'm just so happy I'm playing Path of Exile again. So glad to be back, and I'm glad that you know, there are people who are watching. I hope you guys are enjoying this series too, and I hope you guys are enjoying this league as well. You know, do you think, like, if you guys think there are some weird points about this league, if you don't like certain points of this series, please let me know. You know, I'm always ready to take suggestions. But yeah, but I just want to say, this league is, so far, it's one of the best ones I've played. Honest to God. I'm being sincere here. Alright. Was that the boss? No, it can't be. Multiple traps. This is a pretty big area. Totems and quantity. Alright, here's the boss. Was that Arc Lightning? Wow, get wrecked. Alright. Veil Vessel. What challenges are in Cruel? Do I have to, full clear? I mean, I'll full clear this area and see if we can accomplish, if we can get any challenges. I don't really remember. Eight monsters remain. How about now? Zero remain. Alright, it's full cleared alright. Even in Cruel, we are doing very well. And I think this life buffer that we have, around 1600 HP, it's a good number. It's a good number. It does not mean that I'm going to move into specking damage. No, we definitely need those endurance charges. But, oh, do we finish another challenge? Somebody wants blood magic for one elk. Yeah, sure. Blood magic. Blood magic. Here you go. And I should go back and restock. Where do you buy blood magic anyways? Blood magic? Here we go. It costs one chance to buy a blood magic, and I get one elk in exchange. I mean, for one chaos, I can get like seven chances, and for three elks, I can get one chaos. It's a small amount, the margin is pretty small, but I'm making four... Whoa. I'm making four, four elks, or four fusings, because sometimes they sell a gem for four fusings, for a fusing, and, they're bought for one chance as well. But I'm making four chaos, or four elks, or four fusing at a time, right? Or for every seven gems that I sell. It's a very small amount, it really is. But it adds up over time, especially if it's something that, you know, the only time it takes you is to go back to town. And some people would say, you know, that's inefficient going back to town and everything, but for me, it's like a way to take a break, you know? So it's a pretty easy way to make currency, I believe. For very little effort on your own, or on your side. Everyone needs gems, man. That's just how the game goes. There's a little bit of supply and demand on that, and I think people have stopped selling gems. Simply because they think, oh, I can just buy whatever gem I want on the vendor. And the ones I can't buy, I'll buy it on poe.xyz. So who's the one supplying? It needs to be somebody. I just don't think there are enough suppliers out there. And the ones who are supplying, they're like overpricing their gems. Anyways, it's a good way to take a little bit of breather from grinding all day, you know? Every now and then someone wants to make a trade, you TP back, go to your hideout, do a trade, and then come back to farming. It's like a nice change of pace, that's how I see it. That's why I do this. Alright, what's the time? 38 minutes. Okay, so after Hail Rake, we probably call it a day. And the reason I'm doing Hail Rake, even though it's kind of an optional quest, is that, it's part of a challenge. And once again, this league, I'm trying to do as many challenges as I can. And in order to finish your challenges, you gotta start early. Even though it's such a pain in the butt to do, if you start early, it doesn't feel as bad. Because it feels like you're doing your normal process. It's kind of like, you know, cleaning your room every day. If you take 10 minutes and clean your room every day, it'll save you a lot of hassle over having to, you know, do one big, like, cleaning session over the weekend. That one's gonna take a long time. Because you haven't been maintaining the house for a long, you know, for like 2 months at a time. And then you go in your bathroom, you clean your toilet, and it's all dirty and shit, and you're like, wow, how did this happen? It's because you haven't been doing maintenance, man. Or if you don't do maintenance on your car, you know? Eventually it's gonna break down. When you could have just changed the oil, you know, once every 4 months or whatever. Anyways. Alright. Let's take a life flask. Avengers. Thank you. Do I actually want to wear this? No, my current helmet gives even more. It gives more resistance, I think. I'm quite sure. Actually, no, it doesn't. Yeah, it does. Yeah, okay. Flasks. These are utility flasks, so let's put those here. And we can pick up three more prophecies. So what's this? You will slay a foe who drops four identical rare items. Okay. Discover a series of indoor chambers flooded with rats. You will travel to the old fields where you will encounter and slay an army of the undead. Okay, so that's an Act 2 quest. That's it. Okay. Wait, another hidden veil area. Did I not finish this? Okay, whatever. Three alt for level 5 blood rage. Three alts? Three alts? Blood rage. So it's one elk? Yeah, sure. Okay, well, let's get this guy in our party first. Fusing. Cyclone. Cyclone for fusing. What happened to that guy who wanted blood rage? Oh, okay. Put it back here. How much do I buy blood rage for typically? Blood rage PoE. Blood rage is purchased for one alt, one or one alteration. So if he offered three, that's a two alt profit. I guess there was no reason to not sell it. Should have acted faster. This is what happens when you don't know the prices, I guess, of gems. Oh well, we still managed to get a fusing out of the cyclone. Let's go restock. Cyclone. Cyclone. Cyclone is bought from Act 3 for one orb of chance. Cyclone. Restock. There we go. Okay, that's it for this episode. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, as always, you can leave a like and subscribe to my channel, or follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/emnixplace. Yeah, otherwise, keep in touch, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.